Okay, we're going to head out of Pier 39 here, which anchors the east end of Astoria, Oregon, onto US 30 or Leif Erickson Drive and get right into a Goonies filming location. Now, in addition to the Goonies, Astoria has been the filming location for quite a few other movies. Kindergarten Cop, Short Circuit, Free Willy, Into the Wild, The Black Stallion, The Ring 2, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3, and the classic cinematic masterpiece, Benji the Hunted. All right, we're at the house now here. And as you can see here, there is a lot of signage directing you to where you can go and where you can't go. In addition to the city, no parking signs. So I'm right behind the no parking sign here. It's easy parking, and you can see it's only a couple hundred feet till you reach the house, if you get in where I got in there. Obviously, it's a private drive, but it's really welcoming to everyone, the Goonies fans, whom they refer to as Goonies. As you can see, they direct you, this is where you want to go. And yeah, you walk up here, you'll see Mikey's house here on the right. You'll see Data's house on the left. The zip line is no longer there, however. But yeah, you'll usually see some people up here or people coming to and from the house. On a typical summer day, the house will see well over 100 visitors.
That's Harry Carey, Ma.
I read an article where the current owner of the house spoke about a woman whose son had died and The Goonies was his favorite movie. She had brought his ashes to Oregon, and the owner asked the mother if she wanted to scatter some of the ashes in the garden, which she said was in full bloom. So she and her family did just that. It's part of owning the house, she said. Actually, back in 2015, the other owner of the house was outside gardening, and I got into a good conversation with him. And afterwards, I asked him if I could take a photograph of him, to which he obliged. This is it here. Now we're going to head to another filming location from a different 80s classic starring good old Arnold Schwarzenegger, Kindergarten Cop.
He's gay.
It's a fire alarm!
What kind of a man teaches kindergarten? He's obviously gay.
Now, actual students at the school were used as extras in the film, and the studio even gave him a new playground. That being John Jacob Astor Elementary will lend a good segue into the history of this town named Astoria. The region here was first home to the Clatsop Band of Native Humans. Astoria was founded in 1811. It's the first and obviously the oldest American settlement west of the Rocky Mountains, keyword being American, which essentially makes it the Jamestown of the West. It's where the largest river in the Northwest meets the Pacific Ocean, huge salmon industry, as well as logging industry. The Lewis and Clark expedition spent the winter here in 1805-1806 at Fort Clatsop, which was a small log structure just southwest of modern-day Astoria. The expedition had hoped a ship would come by that could take them back east, but instead they were forced to endure the harsh winter, and they had to later return overland by internal rivers, the exact same way that they had traveled west. When wealthy New York tycoon John Jacob Astor hears of all the beaver a man could want in the Northwest via the reports of the Lewis and Clark expedition, he sends a party to establish a settlement at the mouth of the Columbia before the Russians coming from Alaska, the Spanish coming from California, and the British headed from Canada are able to do so themselves. It was 1810 when his merchant ship, the Tonquin, left New York with the Pacific Fur Company, his company, to start his fur trading post. The Tonquin navigated around the southernmost tip of South America, took a little stop over in Hawaii for some pineapple, and then sailed into the mouth of the Columbia and made land here in mid-April of 1811. They actually had newly acquired native Hawaiian workers that they took with them to Astoria, and work was begun on what would later be called Astoria, named after a man who would never even visit. Thousands of men who passed through Oregon from 1850 to the 1950s were a victim of Shanghaiing, the practice of sending unwilling men out to sea, usually to serve on ships lacking full crews, that earned Astoria its reputation as what one late 19th century reporter called the most wicked place on earth for its population. And this is the Lower Columbia Bowling Alley, which was built in 1956.
It's the most amazing thing I ever saw!
Oh wow, a police chase!
Okay, we're going to take a turn here on 8th Street, and we're going to stay with the Goonies here. So we're coming up on the Captain Flavelle House Museum. This was home to Astoria's first millionaire. It was built in 1885, and the house actually occupies a full city block. The guy was a baller. And, of course, it's haunted. Allegedly. There's allegedly phantom music that's played by the Flavelle sisters, which in recent years has taken on more of a mumble rap vibe, along with an occasional appearance by dear old dad. Alright, as you can see, we're heading uphill, and we're headed to the hilltop area of the city. Fun fact, it's been 125 years since you could die in Astoria and be buried there. The city prohibited burials within the city limits beginning in 1897. There were once several cemeteries around Astoria, but the Hilltop Cemetery, where we're going to pass by here, it's the only one that hasn't been paved over or built over. It's estimated that as many as 700 burials may have occurred at the Astoria Pioneer Cemetery between 1865 and 1897, but records are spotty and the dead have moved around multiple times. With the assistance of living humans, although it's reportedly haunted as well. One persistent story involves a mass grave, or the unmarked graves, of hundreds of Chinese workers at the borders of the cemetery under what are now these hilltop city streets. In the years preceding the 1882 signing of the Chinese Exclusion Act, one-third of Astoria's population were native Chinese, with the balance of the population being mainly European immigrants. All right, we're going to start heading downhill now from the Hilltop neighborhood, where you start getting really, really great views of the Columbia River. As far as weather goes in Astoria, there's actually, on average, 4 days with temperatures exceeding 80 degrees. It's pretty humid, too. It's tied with Lake Charles, Louisiana, and Port Arthur, Texas, as the cities with the highest average humidity in the United States. It averages about 89% in the morning and 73% in the afternoon here. It's claimed that the legendary actor Clark Gable began his career at the Astoria Theater in 1922, which would have been the same year as the 1922 fire, obviously. The newly built Liberty Theater, built in 1925, was said to have played host to the likes of Jack Benny, Guy Lombardo, Duke Ellington, and even Al Capone. Of course, it's home to a ghost, whose nickname is Handsome Paul, who appears suited up and ready for a night out. And then there's also the apparition of an elderly woman who has allegedly been seen as well.
Well, I got a really special friend named Willy.
Why would he want scraps?
Well, he's a whale.
A whale?
Yep, that's the fish market where the young boy Jesse in the movie Free Willy goes to get fish to feed the whale, named Willy. The story is also well known among road enthusiasts, such as myself, because it marks the west end of U.S. Route 30. It's the only remaining U.S. highway that has always been coast-to-coast, from the time U.S. routes were commissioned in 1926 up until now. Astoria is also the end of the Transamerica Bicycle Trail, which is a 4,250-mile coast-to-coast bicycle touring route that was created in 1976 by the Adventure Cycling Association. And that same road is currently taking us towards U.S. 101, and the most prominent landmark in Astoria, the Astoria Magler Bridge. It's pretty tough to miss it from anywhere really in Astoria. It spans the whole mouth of the Columbia River and is really just a beautiful piece of engineering that's able to withstand winds of 150 miles an hour even. And the bridge was featured prominently in the movie Short Circuit in the backyard of Steph's house.
This is my home, it's not your home, I live here.
That's what I just said. Anyway, before the bridge was finally completed in 1966, critics of the bridge, they nicknamed it the Bridge to Nowhere, even though it provided the final link in the U.S. highway system between Mexico and Canada when they opened it up to traffic. It spans the entire mouth of the Columbia River. It's 4.1 miles long, making it the longest three-truss bridge in the world. It also holds the record for the fastest speeder ever clocked by the Oregon State Police. The vehicle was traveling at 159 miles per hour. And to lend a little bit of perspective on what that offending gentleman or lady might have seen through their windshield going that speed, I've sped up this video to 160 miles an hour. Which also gives us a segue into the last movie reference and the final moments of this video here. Johnny Five getting chased by that evil, evil robot. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Schroeder, what do you got? Over.
He's right in front of us, sir. We're on the bridge out of 101. Over.
We're on our way. Lose it and you're dead meat.